15 minutes. Oh, I have to do my clap. Clap. What's up, guys? I'm Lewis, and I'm here with Nick. Say hi, Nick.
Hi.
And we're here to give you the news you knew already. Our weekly recap show of 5 stories from last week that we think you should know about. And then we'll give you the releases for the upcoming week. So let's get going. First up on the docket, The Witcher 3 has gone gold this week. That means it's going to get printed. That means it's done. That means it's actually coming out at the release date they gave this time, which is awesome. We're all super excited for The Witcher 3 and hope you are too. It should be a great game. It looks really cool from the stuff we've seen of it so far. Other news includes the release timing of the game on the day of release. So May 19 is the release date. It'll be coming out 1 a.m. May 19 CET, which is Polish time. What that means for us in the United States is that 4 p.m. Pacific, 7 p.m. Eastern time, those who've downloaded and preloaded the game will have access right away, which means you get extra time to play before everybody else.
This week was Star Wars Celebration in Anaheim. They released a trailer for the new movie, The Force Awakens, as well as Star Wars Battlefront. Star Wars Battlefront will be coming out November 17. None of us on the podcast went to it, but it'll be all right.
Next up, Mortal Kombat X has some weird DLC. First up is a $20 unlock that gives you access to everything in the crypt. It's a one-time fee, and you'll get all the unlocks without having to do all the in-game playing to get them. The other thing is a $1 for 5 or $5 for 30 easy fatality tokens. What these are tokens which enable you to bypass the button press combination, which activate the fatalities, and instead press a single button to execute the fatalities. These items are consumable, so once you've burned through your stack that you've purchased, you'll have to buy them again if you want them. Here at the podcast and show, we'd like to recommend that you go ahead and skip this and go ahead and learn the fatalities and save yourself some money because it's not worth it. Nick says buy DLC characters. Nick also says that unlocking everything in the crypt in-game is hard, so maybe that's not so bad.
GameStop will be selling retro consoles and software. We're not too keen on this. I think they need to be doing whatever they can to up sales, but that's cool for collectors. Hopefully they won't screw you over with their sales, but we'll find out. It's in test markets across the United States. It's in test markets. Oh, okay. They're putting it in test markets. It's in test markets, and if it goes well, hopefully we'll see it across the United States.
Last but not least, Destiny has announced its expansion timings. Last week, Bungie announced the release timings for the House of Wolves DLC for its big game, Destiny. If you don't know what Destiny is, where have you been? If you still like Destiny, welcome to the Sad Club. We're still here too. First up, on April 22nd, which is Wednesday, next week, or this week, rather, they will be releasing information about the Reef social area, as well as the upgrade paths for both legendary and exotic weapons, it looks like. In their photo, they show what looks like Fatebringer going from 300 to 366, or whatever the new damage cap will be. Second, on Wednesday, April 29th, Bungie will be releasing details about the Trial of Osiris gameplay and what exactly the rewards for that will be, which include endgame armor and weapons. Based on the picture, everything looks super Egyptian, which is no surprise since it's called Trials of Osiris. What the gameplay entails, I don't think anybody knows yet, but hopefully we'll find out in a couple weeks. Finally, Wednesday, May 6th, we'll be learning about the Prison of Elders cooperative 3-player game type. Not much has been announced about that other than it's going to be a 3-player cooperative game type, which means you can group up in fire teams and go, we're assuming, play a horde mode and shoot some stuff in Destiny. So you can play more Destiny. I don't know. It's Destiny. Yay. Here's Nick with the upcoming releases for this week.
This week for releases, we have Shovel Knight on PS platforms, Infinity Runner for the PS4, Crypt of the Necrodancer for PC, Dungeons 2 on PC, and Omega Quintet on the PS4. That's it for us. If you guys like our video, like, subscribe, comment below. We're on, our blog is andnowjustlisten.wordpress.com. Our Twitter is @ANJLTweets, and you can email the podcast at andnowjustlisten@gmail.com. We'll see you next week with more news.
Bye!
Oh, look at the camera. Got you. You were looking at me, giving me weird faces.
Not here.
Ta-da!